speak in my mother tongue and somebody will translate, but to save valuable time of yours, so I will try to speak in English. If I made any mistakes, please pardon me. I didn't study in English medium convents. So my mind both way try to articulate in Telugu and it try to translate in the same. So it plays dual role. So if something fight will happen here, I will stuck. Then I will take help of Ravi. Just when I am sitting there, you are very seriously discussing about your organizational matters. I got feared how I will take this group into very complex and serious issue of land. So I will try my best. India is nearly 65 to 68% people are living in the villages. Their basic livelihood is depending directly or indirectly in the agriculture. The remaining people lives also depending in the agriculture, because the science so far not created an alternative for the food. So wherever you go, you are linked with the agriculture. So when the major population, Indian population living in agriculture and living in villages, 7 lakhs villages, if you want to think about justice, democracy, whatever, unless we should understand the relation, land relations, and the issues relating to the land, actually we can't open the key. That was said by Ambedkar. So that's why land is very much important, crucial issue. Historically, economically, politically and mythologically. You may know, all people know about Bharatam. So, these 5 brothers of Pandavas, they spent 14 years in exile, 1 year in underground. That is called Aranyavasa and Ajnatavasa. And they fulfilled their promise when they defeated in the Nematon Zoro. And finally, according to their agreement, they send a ambassador or what do you call it?
Consultant.
In modern terminology, consultant Krishna, to negotiate. We fulfill all these your demands, 14 years and 1 year. So give it back our land. Then Duryodhana was refused. And Dharmaraj knows this. So he tells the Krishna that first demand is this. Then second demand, if he didn't agree, at least ask him to give 5 villages, because we have 5. He refused. Then there is a big war. So if you take any of our cultural link, historical, political, it come and rest with the land. So that's why I request you all the chapters volunteers. This class may not be give a full-fledged understanding. Unless we want to understand India, we should read, study, discover what is happening on the land thing. It's a big task. But if you love your country, you must go through this process. So with that caution, memalani bayapadutunnanu nenu.
He's asking whether he's caring all of you.
So that's why what I want to do is that I am not an qualified, I didn't belong to any academic discipline, either social science or natural science. I am a grassroots worker. I studied when the situation demands. I wrote when the situation demands. So like that, my education is నాట్ ఏ సిస్టమేటిక్ వే. ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఏ దానేమంటాము చాలా అనార్కి. సో ఐ కాంట్ గివ్ ఏ సిస్టమేటిక్ వ్యూ ఆన్ ది సబ్జెక్ట్. ద మై స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఈజ్ మై ఫీల్డ్ వర్క్. సో దట్స్ వై ఐ విల్ నెరేట్ యూ 3 స్టోరీస్ అండ్ ఐ విల్ ట్రై టు డిస్కస్ బిహైండ్ దట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపనింగ్ బిహైండ్ దట్ స్టోరీస్. సో ఐ విల్ స్టార్ట్ మై ఫస్ట్ స్టోరీ. ఆల్రెడీ వేసారా మీరు? నెక్స్ట్ లేట్. ఇది ఒక సాటిలైట్ ఇమేజ్ ఇది. సో ఐఎమ్ ప్రిపేరింగ్ ఫర్ మై గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్స్. ఐఎమ్ ట్రయింగ్ టు బై హార్ట్ ది ఆన్సర్స్ అండ్ యూ ఆల్ నో ది హౌ ది ఎగ్జామినేషన్స్ విల్ బి కండక్టెడ్ అండ్ మై సమ్ ఆఫ్ మై ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఇస్ యాక్చువల్లీ ట్రయింగ్ టు మొబలైజ్ దళిత్ కమ్యూనిటీ ఇన్ ఏ విలేజ్. దట్ ఈస్ దిస్ విలేజ్ నాట్ ఆల్. అండ్ వన్ ఫ్రెండ్ హీ డిస్కంటిన్యూడ్ హిస్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆంధ్ర యూనివర్సిటీ ఈజ్ యాక్చువల్లీ టీమ్ లీడర్ ఆఫ్ దట్ టాస్క్ అండ్ హీ మెట్ మీ ఇన్ మై హౌస్ అండ్ హీ రిక్వెస్టెడ్ మీ సో వీఆర్ ట్రయింగ్ టు మొబలైజ్ ది కమ్యూనిటీ బట్ వీఆర్ అన్ఫార్చునేట్లీ going forward our efforts, so could you help us because I have a little bit, I am also bathroom bhagavatar, I can sing, I have a little bit talent on that, so why can't you come or join with group. Then I told I am preparing for examinations, how it is possible. No, you come at least 3-4 days, just then you can go. The first time as a I visited this Dalit Wada, Dalit colony. This village, this Dalit colony has two important features. Generally in India, the scheduled caste people habitations is outside of the main village. Undarramalapeta uri chivara కష్టాలున్న చోట ఊరి చివర కష్టాలున్న చోట. ఎవ్రీ దళిత్ విలేజ్ జనరల్లీ లొకేటెడ్ వేర్ ది బరియల్ గ్రౌండ్ ఈస్ దేర్ నెక్స్ట్ ది బరియల్ గ్రౌండ్. కష్టం, కష్టం మీన్స్ హార్డ్షిప్ బికాస్ 80-90% ఆఫ్ ది షెడ్యూల్డ్ కాస్ట్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ది అగ్రికల్చరల్ వర్కర్స్. Can this Dalita Wada is a uniqueness. This Dalita Wada is situated in the middle of the main village. How it is happened? I try to discover but nobody give a proper answer for me. Generally Dalita Wadas are outside of the main village but this Dalita Wada is in the inside of the main village. Second thing, this is the Dalita Wada second largest population of Dalit community if you compare it to the statistics. First is your Paikarapeta. So that's why Paikarapeta constituency reserved for scheduled caste. That is this way. The second largest Dalit community is in this village. But an incident took place before we gone to that village. Next. In 1980, that day is the local village celebration taking place. And in the local village celebration, cockfights will be organized. Nowadays, even our honorable ministers also participate. For that, our great MPs conducted a dharna because one SP obstructed last year. Because it is under prohibited under the law. But these MPs conducted a dharna to for a right to organize the cockfights at the Kodupunju, correct? Na?
Yeah.
There is a little bit commotion take place. Taking that advantage of that commotion, this upper caste people attacked the entire Dalit encircled and they burned their village. horses, and nearly 5 to 6 persons very badly got injuries. Remaining men ran away, leaving the women. That is the day. So when this incident took place, the district collector is Mr. P. Arjun Rao, the first generation of Dalit IAS officer, is in charge of the Vizag district collector. Next. So he visited that village, and this is the new colony. He unmarked a site and gave the house pattas, and this was the first time Dalits were taken away from the middle of the village to the outside, their historical place. And all the site which is earlier enjoyed by the Dalits was occupied by the foreign communities. So after this 1980, this was happened. So we went that village in between 1983-84. Just I didn't remember which month actually I went there. So the memories is very fresh on the Dalit minds. So what is their situation? There is no land. And for the survival, again they should go to the fields of the upper caste people who beated them, who burned their village houses. Because you want to survive, you should go to and do work. And there is a migration to the delta area of where green revolution took place in Andhra Pradesh. That is it, we call it survival migration. Because of your livelihood, you should force it to migrate for a daily wage labor to the delta areas. That is the situation. And still there is a discrimination is going on, and Dalits were not allowed to the tea shops, and many kind of these things are there. So the group which started working there, they identified a big patch of land that is next to the Dalitavada. So that is classified as a government wasteland. And this group thought that if we will organize the Dalit community, and if we will get that land, so their position will be changed. That is the motive, and they started working. But because of fear, because of, you see, they don't know if they went to the land, what will happen. Because this empty land was used by the forward caste people for their cattle. So that's why people are not coming. This group again and again went and discussing, trying to educate and bring unity. So that is the situation we went. I went there for 4 days. And we observed that the best group tried to convince the women folk. So we then changed our strategy. We approached to the women. For that, we wrote a song. నాతవరములో నాగళ్ళను పట్టి బంజరు దున్నా పోతే పంటలు తీయబోతే. లాంగ్ బ్యాక్ ఐ రోట్, ఐ డిడ్ంట్ రిమెంబర్ ది నెక్స్ట్ స్టాంజస్. దట్ సాంగ్ యాక్చువల్లీ క్రియేటెడ్ ఎ వైరల్ అంటే ఇట్స్ క్రియేటెడ్ ఎ ఫైట్. దెన్ ఫస్ట్ ఉమెన్ కేమ్ అండ్ దే ఛాలెంజ్ ది మెన్. ఇఫ్ యూ ఫియర్ పోలీస్, ఇఫ్ యూ ఫియర్ అరెస్ట్, ఫస్ట్ వీ విల్ గో అండ్ అరెస్ట్. Then men also got some kind of, when women were challenged men, they were powerful. Then slowly people are getting strength. And what we did is that we also identified the poor from the BCs. And we also identified the poor from the OCs. That group actually attacked the Dalits. But still, to build a unity, then we organized. And there is a small group of tribals are also there in that particular colony, 20 families. So there is a big unity between Dalits, backward communities poor, and OC community poor, and Dalits. So it takes us 1 year to occupy Wall Street, but it is occupy wasteland. So the people occupied the land and they got the next slide. Mr. Ashar Shankaran, a great Indian bureaucrat, is a real meaning for an officer. He belongs to Tamil Nadu. He was born in a Brahmin family. He was selected IAS and elected to the Andhra Pradesh cadre. From the day one sub-collector and until his death, his entire life he sacrificed for the to uplift of the Dalits, Adivasis, poor in Andhra Pradesh. And he said, if you analyze the caste system in a rural area and you analyze your land relations, if you superimpose on these two, it matches all the lands, cultivatable good lands was owned by the so-called upper caste, and remaining backward communities and the Dalits are the lower strata, which is the agricultural workers. So the caste hierarchy and the land relations are same. So caste hierarchy is a ladder. Every caste has a one upper caste and there is a lower caste. So like that, the uneven social relations and the uneven land relations. He said, if you want to change the Indian society, if you start with the change of uneven land relations, there is a link. Because power comes to the upper caste people. How? Why? They are holding the prime lands on the village. That is the key of the entire agricultural economy's runs. So he said, if you see the system of the a village, so upper caste to lower caste and the landed rich and middle peasantry and agricultural labor. So that's why these IAS officers like Shankaran, B.N. Yugandhar still alive, he worked as a prime minister's personal secretary and planning commission member, and his son here is the Microsoft company CEO, such an Adil. And these the group actually behind the curtain worked for the land reforms in India. This is the committed officers. Their names never come into the mainstream media. Many people say about Indira Gandhi XYZ. This is the people who worked without getting any credit. And he said this thing. Next. And Ambedkar said, there is a big debate about the village before the freedom movement, after the freedom movement. Three icons in India visualized village and its future differently. One is Gandhi, which I always see his photo in AIDS website. And second is Nehru, third is Ambedkar. Three has a different kind of opinion on the village and the future of the village. So Ambedkar said, when the predominantly agricultural people are depending in the agriculture, so what is the untouchables, untouchable status in the agriculture? What is the untouchable status in the in a rural society? They can't, they didn't have a land. And if they try to get some land, they all will gang up and oppose. Even though they have some kind of earnings and savings, they can't purchase land. And Mr. Kaki Madhavrao, he worked as a chief secretary of Andhra Pradesh. He is the second generation of IAS from the scheduled caste. Once he narrated his life story, and he told us in the meeting, when he was selected as IAS officer, he went to his mother and he asked his mother, Amma, neeku em kavali? What I should do? Because now I became an IAS officer. Nana, naaku okka rendu ekaral bhoomi koni pettarani adigina. Plus, just you purchase 2 acres.
Just buy me 2 acres.
2 acres of land. just in a entire life, generations, they worked as an agriculture workers. They know how to do work agriculture, but they never hold a piece of land. Unless you transfer into that mind, you can't understand why they so much demand for land. Because it gives you a social respect, it gives you a security, it gives you a atma viswas, self-confidence. It promotes you in a ladder of the hierarchy. It gives you credit worthiness. Suddenly you want 10,000 rupees. Now you say that I have a land here. So land, when you got a land, a Dalit community got a land, so many things, so many changes will took place silently. So that's why each and every Dalit agricultural labor's dream is that a piece of land they want. Mr. Sainar, I thought that he came here and he participated in aid conference. Once he wrote, he went to the Nalgonda district, he interviewed a sarpanch of Banjara community. Because he learned about him, he did a big fight for a land. So it gave some kind of power, and the people was elected him as a sarpanch. And he asked him that, could you show me the land? And both went to the land, and Sainar stunned, because all this land was with rocks. For this land you made struggles? Yes, sir. Why? Sir, even though it is a rocks, now I have 2 acres of land. Now I will go to the bank and get a loan. Now marriage relations, I will say, we have 2 acres land.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the importance of the land in India. So, next slide. It takes us 1 year, mobilize the people and went to the land and clear the bushes. And they started first cultivation, and the produce is they took to their houses. All this process, it takes 1 year. I went there for 4 days. Unless when the crop is came to their houses, that day we left the 2 years. It takes 1 year. So I am not able to write my graduation, but I wrote real examination in that place. Next slide. This is the land. So if anybody visits India, if you have a time, make a time and come to me, and I will show the casuarina tops. This time, this season, each Dalit family, each BC family got nearly to 30 to 40,000 rupees. It's not a small amount for a rural poor. Then what happened? What kind of changes this land holding brought to that the poor? Next. After 1 year we left, on 1986, January 26th, the lease pattas was granted by the revenue department. And that same day, 1950, the Constitution of India came into the force, which promised the justice to the poor. The redistribution of land in favor of the rural poor free them from exploitations, strengthens labor and credit markets, and provide the beneficiaries with a source of sustenance as well as economic and social status. That is the words Shankaran said. Is it real or not false? We will see the Nathwaram. Next. This is the changes I observed. I didn't any research, but we are observing day and night there. So before NRGS, the migration was stopped. That is the first change. Second stage, self-employment. You need not go to the landlords or who actually attacked you, you will not go, because you have a lot of work in your own field. So first you will do. When this labor doing their own labor in their field, that is the time actually the landowners need the labor. So that's why the wages were increased. And they are coming begging, please come my field. You can't imagine 1980 before that. Now they are requesting labor, please come and do my work. So because his first responsibility is, first I will do my work. You know? Next, decrease of caste discrimination and intra-caste marriages was increased. And graduates, post-graduates, professionals from second and third generation grown from that Dalit and BC community. And political accession brought the government welfare programs. That is the Dalit Wada, which all the roads now you can see the cement roads. Now there is a single thatched house, there is no single thatched house. There is a drinking water, protected drinking water facilities came, street lights is came. And their credit worthiness is increased, and they went to the banks and getting loans, and a girls hostel was opened there, and school was sanctioned there. Why? Because there gives a political strength. MPTs as well as elected, Gram Sarpanch was elected from the Dalit community, and the ZPTC elected from the Dalit community. And Nathwaram Mandal Prajapashad chairman was one Dalit there. So land gives a strength. Actually the Panchayati Raj, what we say that the actual reservations, if you see wherever they didn't have a land and strength, there they are called dummy Sarpanch. And the name Sarpanch is a Dalit, he sits in the ground, and the forward caste people sits in this chair in Gram Panchayat office. But here you can see a complete reverse picture. And if you go into the, just you glance, if you see the Dalit Wada, you can observe that this, something is different here. If I didn't say anything, just I will take you into this, put you in the street, just you say that, it's something is different. It is not like normal Dalit Wada. What happened here? It has happened here, the land was came to the Dalit's hands. Next. And he said, it gives you, it is only an economic asset. Please remember, in India, it is not like a computer. It's not like your house. It's a completely different kind of link will give when you have a land. Something even we can narrate it. But if you see a landless Dalit and a land Dalit, you see the comparison, how they speak, how they stand, how they wear their clothes. Complete difference. If I will take you two villages, one Dalit Wada of Nathwaram, in another Dalit Wada where there is no land, you can clearly observe the body language of the people. So like that, after recently 1915 of January 18, remember 1918, January 19, a big attack was taken place on Dalit. This day, Dalits organized a big community festival with Dalits, Adivasis, BC poor, a big procession was taken. Once they ran away for a life, and the same roads they conducted. That is the revolution, I think. That is the change. When it has come to the second generation, you can see the difference of their self-assertion. Next. Recently they organized an eye camp. Any eye camps can be conducted. What is this special? There is a specialty, is there. Some years back I read, when Cuban doctors went to the Bolivia, interior Bolivia areas, for conducting a medical camp. And they are doing checkings. And one old person came, he was suffering with the eye problem. They made treatment and gave some glasses. after the next day they learned that is the person who shoot the Che Guevara, Dr. Che Guevara. It came into the newspapers. Here, when this camp was organized by the third generation of Dalit volunteers, not the forward caste. And there, some of the people who participated in 1980 on attack on Dalits came here and tested their eyes. And the girl who organized it, studied MA social work, and another girl actually brought that whole team, is studying BS optometrician. Both are my daughters. And Ramalakshmi invited one of the old person who participated in the attack to come and garland the Ambedkar photo. So what I want to underline this, unless you understand the importance of the land in Indian society, so we can't really understand what the meaning of change, what the meaning of social justice, what is the meaning of democracy. Next. So I completed my graduation in 2011 with the help of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Open University, Hyderabad. Next. Now I will shift to the second story. Next slide. One day I have a small office in I live in a village, Achipeta. Time is a warning. So one day I have a small office in Anakapilli town. I live in a village called Achipeta. Then I travel from Achipeta to America. To a long journey, many people helped. I remember that help. Okay. So when I close for the lunch and the office, just walking to reach my village, I find out that one old person speaking with a cyclist. This is mine. Something is happening, just I went there. Next slide. The cyclist was gone, and that old person, just I reached him like this, and he gave me a small slip into my hand. And he asked that he want to know that address. I saw it is written my name there. Ajay Kumar office, RTC complex Edruga, Anakapalli. That is the then I saw that old man. You see, this idiledi. So it's gone. So he tied up with a thread. Oh. And the slip was also like that. And small bag. In that bag he carries a water bottle. And nearly he is a 65 to 70 years old man. And I took him to the office. First with silently, I nen cheptan da nik office ani teeskan vella. Next.
He said I'll show you the office. He probably didn't tell that you were there.
Then I am opening door, he scared. Because he thought that I am taking the office, na? He scared and he got like this. Then I make him to comfort and sit and put a fan and I asked why you want to meet Ajay Kumar. Silent. Rural people, unless you give a confidence, they will not. Because many people world motion chesaru.
Cheat them. So that's why they remain silent.
Remain. Even tribal, Mari custom. It's very highly difficult.
Tribal is even harder.
Yeah. Then I asked that, did you eat? It's my silent. I understand that you sit and went to the road and I brought it 4 idlis. And I gave that idlis and I told, you see, I worked with Ajay Kumar. Sir is not there. He went. You can explain. Atanne kalwa. So he want to meet only Ajay Kumar. No, he came. Problem is it will take time because he went outside. What? Then he gave me a small slip. The problem is that simple. He has a 1 acre 50 cents land. That is dry land. that is his only livelihood. And he, his wife is living in the village. His son, daughter-in-law went for migration. And there is no income because he can't do the labor work. So he give it to the, this land for a relatives who can give some amount. After 3 years, this relatives is saying that it is not your land, it is our land. This old man scared and went to the police station and gave a, and sent the essay. Sub-inspector asked that, where is your land documents? And he again took a small piece of paper and showed the essay. Essay said, no, this is not the original document, it is a Xerox. You need full-fledged document, then I will call that person. Then where that full-fledged document will available? Who will give that? Then he approached a small politician in his gram panchayat. He took him 2 months to the mandal headquarters. Every time, chicken biryani, quarter, and the expenses of traveling bared by this old man. After 2 months, he took him to the MRO, Tahsildar. You know Tahsildar?
Yeah.
And Tahsildar, again 3 to 4 visits, he had taken 1500 rupees and give a small typed paper. That is in English. And again he, this old man, took that paper to the SI and SI said, yavadra cheppadi neeku, we need original document. Then somebody suggested that a group is working. If you met that group, you will get the document. That is the story. Okay, next. When a land issue comes for a poor people, whatever land issue is, just you forget about. Any land issue come here, poor people, there is the 4 institutions generally linked with the land related matters. One is the police station, second is the tahsil office, we call it mandal revenue office. 4th is the sub-register office, where the documents were registered. If I sell land to him, both we will go to the sub-register office, I pay money and documentation will be registered there. So all the registered documents will be kept in the sub-register office and the court. When a dispute arises, then a civil matter will go to the court. The 4 institutions will link with the any kind of land matter. But it depends on the nature of the land, a particular issue. Where you should go to the court, where you should go to the tahsil office, when should you go to the sub-register office. If you have a knowledge and skills, we will go to the particular appropriate this thing. In this case, his documents actually available in the sub-register office, not in the tahsil office. So I understand the issue and I called my local volunteer, and within 2 weeks, with the expenditure of 280 rupees, he got the registered deed and certified copy of the registered deed the old man got. Now you understand, 2 months expenditure, 1500 rupees bribe, finally agony and fear, and how it is affect his health and his wife's health, just to imagine. The point is that why it is happening. So we have laws, we have regulations, we have GOs, we have a constitution. To implement those laws, to implement those regulations, we have the institutions. That institutions run by the people's tax. And each institution has a kingdom. Is a Padma Vyuha. You know Padma Vyuha? Abhimanya is know how to enter into the Padma Vyuha, he don't know how to come back. This poor Abhimanyas even don't know how to enter. Forget how to come back. So these all institutions started and running on the cost of people to do the service, to do the justice, to do the implement the laws. But the if you see the gap is like this. Who will fill this gap? Where is the institutional system in India? Where this poor man will go? Tell me the formal institution or informal institution. which college he will tell you what is the sub-registrar office, what is the tahsildar office. Only one person is available, that is the advocate. But his Padma Yoha is court, not the sub-registrar office. Even many advocates don't know what kind of revenue records will be there in tahsil office. And there is no institution in India to address this gap. Forget about land, you take the Narega. So Narega gives you 100 days work as a constitutional guarantee. And you are the entitlement to get the land, 100 days work. But how you will get that right? For that there is an institution called Additional Program Office in every mandal. But how do you go and approach? For that you submit an application for demanding work and take a receipt to your house. Where you get that application? How to write that application? Sir, that is the way there is in number of laws, in number of rights in our country. When you come to the see the implementation is a zero because of this gap. So there is no institution, either formal or informal, to address this gap. Usually we thought that political parties will do this because they are the people who go to the people, who needs the people vote. But they are less interested, I am sorry to say, including communists. They are interested to do dharna. So this gap is not reduced in 60 years. Actually, new laws are coming, new gaps are increasing. Forest Rights Act, I can speak 1 hour on that. But how many Adivasis know how to get a patta from the Forest Rights Act? National Food Security Act. Now each person has an entitlement to get to 5 kgs rice. But which person is go and will sell that this is the right, this is the process, this is the entitlement? Where is that knowledge will come to the people? Simply parliament passed an act, it come a divine and come to the minds of the people of India? Huh? There is a God? No one is addressing this issue. That's why what is happening, law after law. Here they will say proudly, we brought this act, we brought that act. What is that implementation? So that is the basic problem we are facing in India. It is not the, there is no loss. 100%, 100 laws are there. I will give you one example and I will go to the other loss story. And the Mullukoda Dahi question. Yeah. In before 1950, Constitution came into the force. You know, Constitution of India came into the force on January 26. That's why we conduct a Republic Day. This country's president, last Republic Day, he visited. Chest was thumped like this.
Mm-hmm.
And many people don't know that 47 we gave independence, 50 we got the constitution. In between, one law came, it is a revolutionary law. It is called Minimum Wages Act. Minimum Wages Act. Minimum Wages Act notified a particular work or a particular wage. If you pay the less wage on the, it is a contrary to the law. Suppose if Ravi engaged me, he gave 120 rupees. Actually, Minimum Wages Act notified that work, I get an entitlement 250 rupees. What law says that? 6 months imprisonment and 2000 rupees fine for Ravi. How many owners went to the jail? Tehar, Rajmundry, Vajar. How many cases were registered? No. That is the law actually giving rise to the crores of unorganized sector workers in this country. In this means not US, in India. Never implemented. Remember, never implemented. Not by the private sector. The government of India is not implemented in Narega. How they violated their own law? And who will send them to the 6 months imprisonment? In Andhra Pradesh, they are paying less amount than the notified minimum wages amount. I filed a case in Andhra Pradesh High Court. High Court gave an interim order. You should implement the Minimum Wages Act. They never implemented. Then I filed a case against contempt. And Karnataka High Court gave a revolutionary judgment. When statutory minimum wages was declared under the Minimum Wages Act, is a constitutional act, is a constitutional right for the worker, how you will pay the less than minimum wages in Narega? And that judgment was challenged by the Government of India and Supreme Court. Can you imagine? A High Court of Karnataka gives a favorable judgment for an unorganized worker, rural worker. The mighty Indian state challenges that judgment in the Supreme Court. And do you know, if you are an MLA elected for one time in Sasan Sabha, he will get pension for entire his life. If one person is elected for the MP, he will get, even not the Lok Sabha, even Rajya Sabha. They will come indirectly to the Rajya Sabha. They will get entire their lifetime pension. That to which level? It's an equal to an IAS officer. For coming here, I went to the US embassy for my visa application. Meantime, I sat in a open place and saw a TV there. And there is a continuously information flowing. English, Telugu and Hindi. What that information said? You are applying for the H-1B visa. You have these kind of entitlements as a worker. We say that America is a capitalist country, ours is a welfare country. Even you can't find out that information in the Labor Department of the Government of India and the Labor Department of Andhra Pradesh or Telangana or XYZ. But I saw that information in a US embassy, the consulate office in Hyderabad. So, this is the gap. Unless we address this gap, so nothing will happen. So, that's why they have a full courage. So, it will take a lot. Because they know that they never implemented.
They always be happy to make pleasing laws because they won't.
So since 24 years of my work is trying to reduce this gap. You take it any social aspect. Education, the right to education act is there. Women and child welfare, you have an Anganwadi and women and child welfare schemes are there. You take anything. And it links a law, it links a scheme, but there is a delivery system, there is a mechanism, but there is a gap between these people and this mechanism. So that is the actually we will see to how to reduce this gap. There is one question we will put ourselves and go to the next last story. Next slide, na? Ambedkar em chepparante, ok nimisham, last slide. Ambedkar, you all know that he is the drafting committee chairman of the Indian Constitution. So, final draft is ho gaya. That is what the last meeting of Constitutional Assembly in 1949, he gave a historical speech. I request you all, it will evolve in the net. You must read it. You must read it. As a capacity of the drafting committee chairman, he said these words. What is the organs of the state? We can say the two kinds of organs of the states. Macro organs of the state and micro organs of the state. What is the macro organs of the state? Constitution clearly said about five organs. Judiciary, executive, next, legislature, control and auditor general office, election commission. This is the macro institution which was laid down, including their contours in the constitution. But whatever you saw the previous slide, police station, MRO office, APO office, Anganwadi center, is a micro institution of the state. people like that old man don't know about the election commission, but he know about the Anganwadi section. We put in their bad people's hand, the constitution never work. Even if you write a bad constitution, if constitution you put into the good people's hand, it will work. So we can say that proudly ours is a big constitution, but unfortunately that constitution was captured by the mafia. Then a final question. Why any person will help that old man? Why can't that SA help? Huh? Why Ajay Kumar should go there? Can SA, you know that law? He can guide that person. You say this document will available in Chowdhury and sub-register office. You go there. Or he is so kind, he can send a constable with him there. Or Tahsildar, no, don't know. Tahsildar no, because he is the revenue person. He know which record is available, where it is. Why he is not said that old man, please go to the sub-register office? Why he is given in a small piece of paper in English? So, this question obviously leads to the third story. మీరు నన్ను ఇంకొక 5 నిమిషాల్లో నేను ఈ ఫోటో ఇక్కడ చూపించడానికి ఐ టేక్ హర్ పర్మిషన్ అంటే ప్రైవసీ ఉంటుంది బట్ ఐ రిక్వెస్టెడ్ హర్ అండ్ ఐ షీ టోల్డ్ మీ దట్ నో నో ప్రాబ్లం లేదు నువ్వు అమెరికాలో చెప్పు నాకు పాపమ్ వెరీ షార్ప్ లేడీ షీ గాట్ 3 male children and 1 girl children, 4. And her husband works as a private electrician. But most of this income will go like this.
Yeah.
So she very difficult to manage entire family. Huh? Very, chaala dhairyam kaligina stree.
Courageous.
Anni kashtallo, anni baadhallo, she able to identify and occupy a 90 cents of government wasteland, and less than 10 cents, less than 1 acre. With great difficulty, he raised a cashew plantation. For that, she approached me and requested me help him to get a patta. What is the patta? It's a piece of paper which Rajamudra will be. Rajamudra. Sir, Rajamudra.
CEO.
Entitlement.
The land holding. Okay, I went there and I saw her land and the casuarina plantation is there and find out the record. It was classified as a road forum oak. Olden days, it was used to go from one village to another village. Because of the new roads, now nobody is using that. So everybody occupied adjacent rights. And she, this lady also occupied a 90 cents. Then I spoken to the Tahsildar. I spoken to the revenue inspector. The revenue inspector visited that site and he made a favorable report. Suddenly, the elections was declared. Last general election was 2009 general elections was declared. When the elections are declared, election notification will come. When the election notification will come, all this kind of activity should be stopped. Only just routine, day-to-day work. Then her file was stopped. Elections ho gaya. No, new government came. When India, new government came, what will happen? All the offices will be transferred. Because that MLA phones, collector, I need this, that SA will need, Naga need as SA to my conscience. Like that, this will go. So, it will take another some months. In meantime, in the general elections, first time we conducted a campaign that not to sell your vote. Selling your vote means you are selling your country. Selling your country. Vote ammukodam ante deshanni ammukodam. If you are selling means you are actually selling your country. You are selling your future. So, with a very hard summer, we went to the constitution after the constituency after constituency and we distributed pamphlets and conducted street meetings in our own little capacity. We will try and I put this link with 5 minutes video in the YouTube. after you're interested, you can look that way.
Show a few seconds, sir. These elections, Papamma approached me and asked me that, so what happened? I advised him, you go and meet the new Tahsildar. She went and Tahsildar demanded 15,000 rupees. Again, there is an opportunity came, we met and Papamma told this thing. And I said, you pay it. You are all shocked. Why Ajay Kumar saying that? Paying 15,000 rupees. Same shock I saw in her face. First she thought that our saying Ardhan Chesko Lemon. She thought he didn't understand what she
said. Yendi? Yendi? And then again in MRO, but he only chair. Now they granted double academy.
He said, how come I don't have that money?
But hey, no election later, double this could not know.
You got some money during elections, right?
Because I got an information from my volunteer. She collected money from all the political parties. There is social justice. Prajarajyam. Television. Congress. Independent. From all the candidates, MLA, MP. She collected money. What do you think? She keep quiet. She is more than Supreme Court advocate. She put a such a beautiful way arguments, one after another. And I will tell you one other pitch. Neer maare sandra maare sir. First.
If I stop, will everybody else?
Yeah, stop. Second, is there any guarantee if I am not taking money that the new person, the elected MLA will do something? Can you give a guarantee? Like that. I didn't ask any money. They came and given it. Like that is a beautiful Supreme Court advocate. She gave a number of arguments when she collected the money. Then I told, they say, you see, MRO has a power to put his seal on a paper. That will give you right. Now he is selling his power for a 15,000 rupees. And you have a power on the income, election
ballot.
For you sell that your power for 900 rupees. And now when you got an opportunity, you did. And he is getting an opportunity, he is doing. There is no business for me in both. And I asked the same question, MRO, why you are asking 50,000 rupees? He gave the same argument.
For
the staff. And if I am not giving the money to the RDO, he will throw out. Because of that only I am collecting. If I will give you account, he's saying that I will give you how much I pay or I RDO survey like that. So then I asked MRO, why you are demanding? Because you are getting a salary. Then he told me, sir, to come as a MRO to the MRO office, the MLA collected 5 lakhs from me. He will allow me 1 year as a MRO here. Just I am recollecting my capital. I am honest person, sir. Just whatever I invested, just I am collecting, sir. Nothing more, nothing less. Then I asked MLA, this is I narrated to Papamma, and he said, oh Ajay, what should I do here? 20 crores was spent. Everybody asked money, everybody asked biryani packet, everybody asked the liquor. Where I will get the money? Just a simple, I am collecting what I invested. Then Papamma, there's a big silence. What happened?
She never came to me and she never asked me about this patta. But one thing has happened, which I want to share with you. The recent general elections, she didn't take money from any political party. Not only that, in India, the political parties sends the vehicles to your house up to the polling booth, like Raja. When you put vote,
you have to go walk back home.
So we called in Jyotisha, Rajapujya. So when you are coming from your house to polling booth, you just like a queen and king. After you will this thing, you will go. But Papamma, she went with walk 1 kilometer and cast her vote and came back. She never revealed this, but I got that information. That is the change. So last time also, we did a campaign of this. So why, then we come to the second story. Why SA is not set? Why Tahsildar is not set? Because if a correct MLA is there, he will try to appoint a good person, MRO in his conscience, eh? SA in his conscience. Then MRO will like S.R. Shankaran will do the service. No need to fill the gap, aid or APVO. So unless people will realize this link, there is a very beautiful story which generation after generation said in India about the king and his 7 fish story. Yeah, many people know that. So 7, king has a son, 2 sons, they went to the fishing, they brought their fish, and they put it in the sunlight. All the fishes were dry, but one fish was not dry. Why? Oka gaddi meeda addochindi.
A haystack came in the way.
Then why that came addochindi? Because the worker didn't put that grass to the cow. Then why worker is not done? Because he didn't get meals in a proper time. Why he didn't get the meals? Because his grandmother is engaged with his manamadu. Why he is engaged with manamadu? Because he is crying. Why he is crying? This boy went and put his finger into the chemal potemata. And the chemal told that, this is my golden house. When he put his finger, that bite. So that is the link. So it is called cause and effect. There is one book called What is History? E.H. Carr. E.H. Carr is one of the great historians. In 1967, he asked a question, what is history? Everybody laughed. Everybody know that it is past. Explaining what is happening in the past. He gave an answer to that question. So you must read that book. In that book is one chapter, The Cause and Effect. So unless people understand this cause and effect, what is doing today actually costing them 5 years? 5 years. What is taking 900 rupees today, actually they are paying their life. 50,000 rupees. Association for Democratic Rights, they have their website. They calculated how much an MLA investing an award in 5 years, how much is getting from that water. It average is 50,000 rupees. Then who will do this job? Which university? Which paper? Which TV series? Who? Which political party? That is the duty of us. So you do you are interested in that, you do. I am interested in education, I will do. But we are all doing for the village people, no? Unless this will change, education system will not change, MR also will not change, the country will not change. So you link that, you connect that. I am not saying that you are all work for land. You work, there is a show, there is a slide, before the presentation I saw, what kind of projects AD is supporting. I am good, but is that project can you think that this issue is actually in a broader context link this, and they are trying to address in that thing, then the change will come. So what I want to suggest, this national conference of aid volunteers, suppose aid supporting 100 projects, each project working with 10 villages, 1000 villages. I do my own passion and my work, but I will bring this issue in every discussion, in every group meeting, every occasion to the people, and I will challenge the people next general elections. If we will bring it 100 villages in this country, which take a vote, we will never sell our vote. We will cast our vote according to our wishes, but this village, we will not sell our vote. Can you make 100 villages for the next general elections with our all efforts? That is the only way country will move forward. Either pellet or bullet, there is no middle path. There is no middle path. Either civil war or the civil consciousness of the Indian masses. So this I lately recognized. When I recognized, my hair completely transferred from black to white. Now each and every dharna, each and every padyatra, each and every issue, when a person came to approach me, I will try to pitch this issue. I will try to open this issue. I am trying to challenge that person. Our Kiran is... Our Kiran contested as a MP in Karnoolu constituency. You know how much votes he got? 5,000 votes. But each vote, if I have an opportunity, I will kiss that vote. It's a pavitra patra. So, ila kala kadu. Endukosam 5000 votelu okka rupayi aasinchakunda vesina votele.
Those 5000 votes were done without greed for even 1 rupee.
Can we increase that 5000 votes 10,000, 20,000, 50,000? That is the challenge in before us. So I put three challenges. Last slide is yama. Next. From 91 to 2015, 24 years, we fought many battles. We won maximum, but we failed to realize this link. We failed to create this consciousness in the way we are working. When we realized the like a thief, time was passed. This message I want to give my next generation volunteers. We miss it, but you don't miss. So, akari chapter, akari slide, last slide. So, we started our journey with long back with aid. I went to the Sevagram, I don't know the, just I have poor memory. I saw the first time Aravinda and Ravi there. After that, they visited my house. We discussed. Then slowly, we as an institution of aid, APVVU, working together, like NREGs, forest rights, etc. You are giving a critical support to us. Whatever we did in the field, you are also partners. You are also part. Between us, thousands of kilometers distance.